discussion on echocardiographic evaluation of aortic regurgitation demonstrated through multiple images. Echocardiogram in parasternal long axis view shows dilated left ventricle, left atrium, aorta, and a small portion of the right ventricle, which is usually the outflow region. Mitral wall leaflets seen in open position between the left ventricle and the left atrium are thickened. The large aortic regurgitation jet can be seen as a mosaic jet in the left ventricular outflow tract anterior to the anterior mitral leaflet. A portion of the thickened aortic wall can be seen between the aorta and the left ventricle. The AR jet is almost filling the left ventricular outflow tract and extends well into the left ventricle beyond the anterior mitral leaflet, indicating a free aortic regurgitation. Dilated left ventricle, aorta, and left atrium also suggest that the AR is severe. Apical five-chamber view shows the dilated left ventricle, thickened anterior mitral leaflet, and posterior mitral leaflet. In this view also, the AR jet is large, extending deep into the LV, indicating severe AR. Thickening of both aortic and mitral leaflets indicate the possible etiology as rheumatic. Mitral and aortic walls are the most often involved walls in rheumatic heart disease, the former being more common between the two. When there is associated mitral stenosis, the color Doppler jet of mitral flow merges with that of the aortic regurgitation in the left ventricle, as both occur in diastole. But the velocity of aortic regurgitation jet is much higher than that of mitral stenosis, as the pressure difference between aorta and left ventricle in diastole is much higher than that between left atrium and left ventricle. This is a parasternal long axis view from another case. Aortic valve is seen as grossly thickened and calcified. The right panel shows the multicolored jet of aortic regurgitation along the ventricular surface of the anterior mitral leaflet. This is quite an eccentric AR jet, and hence assessment of severity will be difficult. Here is another eccentric jet of aortic regurgitation going along the posterior margin of the left ventricular outflow tract or the anterior mitral leaflet. The systolic frame on the right shows the mitral valve in the closed position, while the diastolic frame on the left shows it in open position. The anterior mitral leaflet shows a reverse doming as the aortic regurgitation jet strikes it. Systolic frame also shows a trivial mitral regurgitation into the left atrium, just behind the mitral valve, as a bluish mosaic jet. Measurement of vena contracta, or the width of the proximal regurgitant jet for grading aortic regurgitation, becomes unreliable when the jet is eccentric. In central jets, a jet width less than 0.3 cm is highly specific for mild AR, and a width more than 0.6 cm is highly specific for severe AR. Eccentric aortic regurgitation has been described in patients with right coronary cusp prolapse complicating a ventricular septal defect. In a study of 129 patients, 27 had moderate aortic regurgitation. Of these, 14 had eccentric aortic regurgitation jets. One of the patients who had mild aortic regurgitation initially had eccentric jet when it progressed to moderate AR. Eccentric aortic regurgitation has been reported in ascending aortic aneurysm. As the usual assessment of severity was erroneous, proximal isovelocity surface area, PISA, method had to be used for quantification of aortic regurgitation. PISA method has been described in another video on this channel. 5 of the 9 patients with mild eccentric AR jets progressed to moderate eccentric AR jets. At the same time, only 7 of 105 who had mild central AR progressed to moderate AR. The authors concluded that eccentric AR is highly likely to progress and is malignant. Here we have both continuous wave Doppler and color Doppler imaging from apical five-chamber view side by side. The right panel shows continuous wave of aortic regurgitation jet. Below the baseline, forward aortic flow is seen, while above the baseline, the tongue-shaped aortic regurgitation jet is seen. Apical five-chamber view in the left panel shows color Doppler image of aortic regurgitation with a wide multicolored jet originating from the closed aortic valve into the left ventricle. From extent of the AR jet into the left ventricle, it is moderately severe AR. Parasternal long axis view showing a small AR jet. Such a small AR jet will be taken as trivial AR with no hemodynamic significance. Left atrium and left ventricle are not dilated. Trivial aortic regurgitation on Doppler interrogation from the apical five-chamber view, which is seen as 2D image in the upper panel. Incomplete image of the jet is obtained when the regurgitant flow is less, as in trivial or mild AR. The jet seen below the baseline is the forward aortic flow in systole, whereas AR occurs in diastole and is seen above the baseline. This is because the regurgitant flow into the left ventricle is towards the transducer in this view. The forward velocity is about 1.2 meter per second, indicating the absence of any associated aortic stenosis. The color bar on the top left indicates that the Nyquist limit of the color Doppler imaging has been set at 60 cm per second. The scale on the left lower side is the Doppler scale in meters per second, with positive values above the baseline and negative values below the baseline. In the apical five-chamber view, the aortic forward flow is away from the transducer and is depicted negative, while the regurgitant flow is towards the transducer and depicted positive. Picture demonstrates measurement of pressure half-time of aortic regurgitation jet using continuous wave Doppler from the apical five-chamber view. Apical five-chamber view with color Doppler is seen in the upper right corner of the image. The Doppler cursor is seen passing through the left ventricular outflow tract and aorta. AR jet is seen as the positive tracing above the baseline. The peak velocity of the AR jet is shown as 4.7 meters per second. AR PHT is shown as 453 milliseconds. The AR deceleration slope is shown as 310 centimeters per second squared. Pressure half time is the time required for the peak pressure gradient to reduce by half, which will correspond to a decrease in peak velocity by a factor of square root of 2. PHT of a regurgitant jet depends on the severity of regurgitation and the compliance of the receiving chamber. If the compliance of the receiving chamber is low, the pressure in the receiving chamber rises rapidly and the pressure gradient decreases rapidly, leading to a steep slope of the Doppler tracing and a low pressure half time. This is the usual situation in an acute aortic regurgitation when the receiving chamber does not get much time to dilate and accommodate the regurgitant flow. Severe regurgitation also gives a similar picture, as the receiving chamber fills rapidly. PHT measurement by Doppler echocardiography is useful in assessing the severity of aortic regurgitation. The severity of aortic regurgitation has been classified according to the pressure half-time as follows: mild AR, PHT more than 500 milliseconds; moderate AR, PHT between 200 to 500 milliseconds; severe AR, PHT less than 200 milliseconds. As mentioned above, PHT depends on the compliance of the receiving chamber and hence it can be reduced by elevated LV diastolic pressure. On the contrary, it can be prolonged if the peripheral resistance is increased and when the aorta is dilated and having a higher compliance. Vasodilator therapy can reduce PHT in AR.